Alright guys, we're home now. Home from work. It's about 10:30 at night. And I'm looking at my little list here. And the only thing that I still have to do is some cardio and weights. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go down to the gym now. Probably be there by about 11. Won't be home till 12:30, I'd say. Got work at 9:30 in the morning. So that gives me plenty of time for post-workout meal, bit of YouTube, and then I'll go to sleep. What else was I going to say? Oh, did do some editing this, tonight. I've got, I'm going to see this. I've got 12 episodes done up already. 12. And I've literally shot enough footage to make another 12 at least. So it's cool, it's fun, it's motivating, it's definitely motivating me, and it's putting me in a good mood, and I hope that you guys like it too. So right now I'm gonna go and train some back. Better get ready. If I'm gonna do some cardio, probably better change my shoes, eh? Man, these are my go-tos, my big black fucking boots. I've got three pairs of them now, but these are still my faves. They're actually basketball shoes, so they're not that good on a treadmill, but in saying that, my Nike Freeruns, which are my other shoes, the sole hasn't worn out, which I'm so like really surprised about. I'm fucking impressed with those shoes, but it has been squished out a little bit, so it's not as solid as it once was. So I find that these blue ones with a nice solid sole gives me a little bit, yeah, more of a solid platform to do cardio on. So. Looks like I've got the whole place to myself. It should be fun. Straps, bottle, towel, music. We're ready. Alright guys, you know what's up. I've got the squat rack over here. I'm going to set up some rack pulls. First set with 60 kgs, second set 100, third set 140, fourth set 180, and then we'll see how I feel after that. So I'm going for four working sets once I work my way up to whatever I'm going to use. Four working sets of 10 to 15, and then I'll probably do a drop set to finish. And you know, usually by the end of rack pulls, if I train at the intensity I normally do, which I always do, I'm usually pretty fucked after that. So I'm just going to set it up now. I've got a full battery for once. I'm going to set up the camera and video the whole thing. So, let go. set for 60 kgs by about 20 reps. Pretty light, just getting used to the movement and getting a small pump in the back. Second set I've just done, which was 100 kg for about, I don't know, 12 to 15, I didn't actually count. And then the pump is sort of starting to come through. Obviously this is the third warm-up set with 140. I'll probably do 10 to 12 reps, nice and slow, stop start, and then the pump will really be there, and then it'll be into some working sets after that. So yeah, get on to this one and I'll see you before my first working set. Alright, so that felt pretty good. Definitely got, you know, challenging towards the end, but I'm going to put another plate on each side. That'll take it up to 180. I don't think I need to go any heavier tonight. I'll just try and match the reps that I did last time, which is 15 reps. So 15 at 180 is where I'm at, and that's where I want to stay throughout this shred, so hopefully I hit it. Alright guys, just a quick word on tap and go versus stop start in the deadlift and the rack pull. Personally, on all of my warm-up sets, I'll probably always use a stop start technique. And I've got no problem using stop start with my heavyweight, but basically I feel that if I want to get out a good amount of reps and I want to make the most of heavy sets with rack pulls or deadlifts, I will use a tap and go technique, which is what I'm going to do tonight. But with my tap and go technique, it's not fast. It's not like drop it and use the bounce to get it back up. Like my range of motion is nice and slow. And on rack pulls, you know, it's below my knee. It's not above my knee, so there is still quite a good amount of range of motion. As you guys have seen, and as you'll see, it's all about time under tension, even on these huge compound movements. It's not all about lifting the weight. I still want to have nice control over the weight, so that's probably why I'm not upping it. I could be lifting more, but you know, I don't have to. I don't need to for what I want to achieve. So, let's get into it. First working set. So that was 15 by my counting. I'll count it back later. I'll be pissed off if it's not, but yeah, that was pretty hard. Could definitely do 20 though, there's no doubt about that. But I'll be looking to hit four sets like that and then a drop set to finish. We'll see how we feel. No belt, obviously, but I'm using straps. 15 reps, set three. Had to take a rest pause, what can I say? But I got it done, and that's what you've got to do. All right, just getting ready for the last set. We've done one more set of 15 with 180, so that's four in total. Now we're going for our fifth working set, which I'm going to make a drop set, as I always do. This is really where the gains are made, man. Like, you know, these last few reps when I get down to 100 kg are going to be just fucking torture. They're going to be burning. And I laugh about it now, but I look forward to it, to be fair. I seriously do, I look forward to it. I want to fucking push myself. You know, when I come to train, I come to train. My movements might be nice and slow, but fuck, the intensity's there every single time. I'll tell you that. I didn't even have pre-workout tonight, so what does that say? That's saying something. All right, so I'll get into this. And you know what? No one's here, so I'm gonna fucking do it topless. Fuck it. See what I look like. So someone walked in while I had my top off, so that was kind of awkward. But rack pulls are done. I'm gonna go over to a lat pull down and fucking pump it out on that. We'll do a sneak peek of the physique. I'm keeping it under wraps because I know I'm making progress. So just a first warm-up set. I mean, a lot of guys would probably, you know, especially after doing something like rack pulls, your back would be pumped, you'd think, fuck it, I don't need a warm-up. But every single new exercise I hit in the gym, in a workout, I'll do a warm-up set, at least one. So I've gone and done it, you know, very light. It may seem tedious, but, you know, touch wood, I haven't had a bad injury yet, so, you know, it's working for me. So first set, I'll use 39. I'll do another warm-up set with 59, and then I'll go to 79, which is pretty damn heavy, especially on this one. At Anytime Fitness, I'm pretty sure I can do, you know, a little bit more than that, but I don't know, the way these pulleys work just seems a little bit harder, so 79 is certainly my working set weight at the moment. So second warm-up set, and then we'll be into working sets. elbows are sore. The inside of my elbow, like right here. Biceps lat pull down's done. I've decided for my second isolation movement, I'm actually gonna go with the bent over row, so it's not really isolation. It's more so isolation when you use the cables. So I've left one plate on each side, and I'm gonna go for AMRAP, as many reps as possible, four sets, and we'll see how I feel after that. So I'm going for at least 20 reps a set, so we'll see how we go. Did not give myself enough time rest between pull downs and doing that. Stupid. Take a good amount of rest and then try and hit 20 clean reps, overhand grip, and then we'll go underhand after that. That wasn't too bad. I'm feeling pretty fatigued now. I've probably been training for about 50 minutes. I haven't actually completed that many sets, but fuck, I haven't eaten much today either, so you know, it's a pretty good session. I'm not gonna hit anything else, it's just back today, so I'll do two more sets on this, and then that'll pretty much be it. And I'll head over there, do some cardio, listen to some podcasts, and then I'll be going home. So I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Hope I've given you some motivation or knowledge bombs or whatever you're looking for in this channel and in this series. Hopefully I'm bringing it to you. Honestly guys, well, last thing I'm gonna say is that underhand grip on bent over row feels so much better than overhand. I don't know if it's just me, but I don't even know why I was doing overhand before. Underhand is where it's at. You can get nice and tight and really, really feel the squeeze. Pull it through your elbows. Overhand's fucked. So I'm doing underhand now. Two straps on an underhand grip. Put one strap on at each time, not both at once. Filled up the bottle of water, got my shoes on, come over here, do some cardio. Now, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. I'm only just gonna do half an hour incline walk. Just keep the sweat going, basically, just keep the heart rate going to therefore keep the fat loss process going. You know, I don't wanna go catabolic. And you know, I've only had probably 80 grams of protein today. So I could possibly go catabolic if I do too much cardio, but I'm gonna do half an hour It's not too much, and then I'll be home to make a pretty decent post-workout meal. Pretty fucking decent. So I can't wait for that. Let's go. Alright guys, so post-workout meal I've made very easy. I cooked up the meatballs meal that I took to work and I didn't have. So I did that workout on just one meal, which is stupid. So I'm definitely getting into this. As you can see, it looks delicious. Or it might not look delicious, but I know how good it tastes, so it looks fucking good to me. Just watching a bit of YouTube. And I'm going to call it a night. It's about 1 in the morning. In fact, 1:02. And bed's calling my name, so I'm going to eat this and then hit the hay. And I'll see you guys bright and early in the morning for another day making gains. All kinds of gains.